Hi, my name is Bill Surrett. I'm a data scientist with Datarobot, and today I want to discuss cross-validation and why this might be necessary for you to properly evaluate your machine learning models. So let's first quickly review train, validation, and holdout. Traditionally, what you do is you set aside a portion of your data, here denoted in gray, as your training data, a portion of your data as validation, and a portion as holdout. You train your models on the training partition. You look at how well the models fit the validation partition so that you can choose one model to put into production. And then we check out-of-sample performance on the holdout data set. Now, there might be a problem here if you don't have enough data or if your data is very noisy. Let's assume we just hold our holdout data set aside and just focus on train validation. We randomly assign records in our data set, some to be validation and some to be training. So if you have a small data set, you might wonder, what if the records that ended up in validation randomly ended up in training? Maybe the records here ended up as validation instead of those. In that case, the out-of-sample validation score might look a little bit different. And the same thing if this were the validation or that were the validation. So what we do is we actually let this validation set vary. We build a model each time, and we average the performance across each of those different validation partitions. In this case, I've broken into five. So we're gonna end up building five models, each one using a slightly different training data set with the validation moving, as illustrated here. So you can see the holdout's been set aside. We took our data here, train validation. That is the validation partition. Then we took that same data, and this time though, we used this section of data for validation, etc. We choose the model that has the best performance on a cross-validation basis, that is across the average of the five validation folds. That becomes our out-of-sample model performance. This is particularly important if you have a noisy data set or if you have a small data set. And that's an overview of cross-validation.